presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll-free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Let's go to Al in Tampa. Hey, Al, what's going on?
Oh, it's a beautiful thing. I mean, if your listeners don't get the gold report, they're missing out. I mean, with your gold report, you're just printing money. I love it.
You're my best ad out there, Al. Let's go to Jeff in New Jersey. Hey, Jeff, what's going on?
Great. Hey, listen, I was calling to thank you. A few weeks ago, you were prompting on your show to fill out that $10,000 grant.
Yes.
So I filled it out, and just a couple days ago, I found $1,000 in my business checking account.
That's awesome, man. That's awesome. Yeah.
And I owe it to you, because if it wasn't for your prompting, I would have just assumed, you know, no way I would have gotten anything. So I wanted to thank you.
No, we appreciate you growling a problem with you.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 7.5 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day in the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, a great week, folks. Always do your best. Surrender and let go of the past. This is a great card. Whatever life takes away from you, let it go. When you surrender and let go of the past, you obviously have to be fully alive in the moment. Letting go of the past means that you can enjoy the dream that is happening right here, right now. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials down 207, Nasdaq's up 39, S&P's down 15, gold contract up $22.70, trading $18.62 an ounce. Silver up 32 cents, $24.58 an ounce. Light sweet crude down 52 cents, $45.74 a barrel. Notes and bonds. The 10-year note up 11 ticks, 137.23. The 30-year up 29 at 172.18 in King Dollar. King Dollar's up 124 ticks, trading 98.25. The euro is at 121. The yen is out here at 104.01. And the British pound's at 133 to 1 U.S. dollar. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world and the world of the S&Ps? Let's take a look at them. What do you have? You got a sideways market out here, folks. We've had a contraction of volume all last week. You're at highs. You're going to have another contraction out here today. You got 30 million shares traded. It's a joke. The bottom line, you took out highs that had 69 million as well as 172 million. NDX 100, we are still at all-time highs. The Qs went to an all-time high out here today. We made it up to 307.63, and the contraction is pretty dramatic out here. You know, we had light volume on Friday, which was which is 19 million. That basically was taking out 50 million, and today we won't do 19 million. Right now you're at 12 million, so pretty intense. Gold contract caught the bid. Bottom line, what you had out here last week is that gold had rejected lower price last week. Goes topside. Now, folks, inside the gold market, inside the silver market, you got ABC structures up all over the place. Bottom line, first off, with the metal itself, you've done 197,000 contracts. You're blowing away the B point out here that at 173,000 contracts. That gives you a price projection of 1910. And the wild thing about 1910, of course, is that you're right back inside the higher range. So I suspect, bottom line, 1910, here we come. We take a look at the silver. Now, what had happened is this. The silver contract was much stronger than the gold contract. It didn't retrace as much. It didn't break any swing lows. Silver wants to go to 30 bucks, man. And this is going to get really interesting with silver. Silver is highly volatile anyway. When this thing moves, it just moves in a vicious acceleration. And if we take a look at, you'll see if I bring this up and we take a look at this, what you're going to see is that silver, I suspect tomorrow is going to break this downtrend that we've been in since August, and I expect what you're going to see is you're going to see a break with conviction. Why? Because it doesn't matter almost what indice you bring up inside the gold market, what equity you bring up inside the gold market, they're blowing away B points with volume. If we go to the GDX, you're going to see the GDX just took out The B point, indeed, at 21 million shares, we're at 17. What does happen with the GDX, folks, is that you will see a huge amount of volume come in at the close. We'll do more than 21 million shares inside of the GDX. Notes and bonds. Let's go to the 30-year first. This is pretty intense what you have. And this is notes and bonds, folks, like the Ever-Ready Bunny. Bottom line, each and every time that you think they're going to go south and stay south, guess what? They pick themselves up. They start higher again. And this one here is a real classic, by the way. Bottom line is that what I've seen, the last two rollovers also, future rollovers, this is how the bonds have been trading. They get smoked. Takes about another couple weeks to get their balance back again, then they go topside. What we had out here last Friday as well as this morning is that you were coming into the strength that was generated out here on November 12th. That's when we went topside. You did it with lighter volume. All of a sudden, you take off again. Bottom line, they both want higher price, lower yield. If we go take a look at the TLT, you're going to see the TLT on Friday came into the last swing low. Last swing low, which was generated out here on November 9th, had 23 million shares. We came into that with 12 million. 12 million to 25 million. Pretty intense, folks. Bottom line, wants higher price. And good old King Dollar. What do we have with King Dollar? When you take a look at King Dollar, what you're going to see, you had a decisive break last week. You broke with conviction. Conviction is wide price spread. You took it apart. About time we took it apart. You get an ABC structure down. That is a price projection of 88. 88 is the next lower swing point. And then on top of that, what you had out here today, and this is why I suspect gold took off in such an incredible way, you had the dollar trying to do a counter trend move. The dollar got up to 91.238, and they just gave it up in spades, man. So bottom line, market-wise out here, these want much higher price, and that is right across the gold market as well as the silver market. We turn around, we take a look at Pan American Silver. Every one of them you can bring up. When you have an ABC market on the way up, folks, okay, inside the gold market, they like doing double and triple ABC structures. You can see Pan American Silver right now taking away the B point. You need 1.5 million shares. We've already done 1.9. That's trading at 31.78. In 31.78, excuse me, you got to go to 31.84 in order to get in the higher range. And I do expect that that's exactly where we're going to get. Some of the higher volume equities out here, and this will be a low volume market, is that you get American Airlines up 76 cents. You get GE down a couple pennies. Ford is off 13 cents. Tesla, oh my God, where do you see this, folks? This is sick. Tesla's on an ABC structure on the way up. This is like, this started this morning. Tommy and I were looking at this. Let me just see if we're going to get the volume. We're going to get the volume. It's going to be close. Hold it. 63 million. No, it's going to be close. You need six. If you get 63 million, Tesla would be a confirmed ABC up to 741. And right now, you're at 646. Pretty amazing. Stay right there, folks. Come right back. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Dow Industrials are down 208. NASDAQ up 34. S&P's down 15. We'll come right back.
Hi, folks. Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
Hi, folks. This is Tom O'Brien. The printing presses are working 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. The U.S. deficit has risen 200% in 1 year with no end in sight. The markets are looking for an additional stimulus bill to get us through this once-in-a-generation pandemic. There is no free lunch, folks. The more stimulus dollars put into the marketplace, the less your dollar is worth each and every day. This is the time to protect yourself with a portion of your portfolio in the metal market. The Gold Report comes out each Monday morning. I bisect and dissect the dollar, silver, gold, the XAU, and the HUI. The Gold Report is a long-term hedge against the dilution of your buying power. The U.S. has put more than $6 trillion into the marketplace in the last 6 months, with more expected in the next few months. The market did and does need the stimulus, but it'll have long-term implications on our buying power. The Gold Report comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee. Go to TFNN.com and order the Gold Report now. Protect your buying power. Order the Gold Report now.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrials down 190. You get the Nasdaq up 44. S&P's down 13.5. Let's go over to our man, Mr. Steve Rose, as we do each and every Monday at 20 past the hour. And don't forget, folks, Steve has an outstanding show here every trading day, 1 to 2 Eastern Standard Time. Also, a great newsletter, Mastering Probability. Now, it's very easy to get Mastering Probability, folks. Come over to our website at TFNN. You're going to go into newsletters. You see Mastering Probability right in the top row. You just hit View, you hit subscribe, you can get Mastering Probability for 1 month for $149. You can get it for 6 months at $695, which is a savings of $199 or 22%. You can get it for a year for $1,195, which is a savings of $593, which is 33%. Now, they all come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, folks. If you like it, great, you keep it. If it doesn't work for you in 30 days, you get your money back. So check it out right on the front page of TFNN. Steve Rhodes, what's going on?
Consolidations, Tom. Consolidations all over the place. And that's what I thought we'd talk about just for a few minutes.
Cool.
And so let me go ahead and put this screen up so that the folks at home can see us. Now, we've got here a picture of the four core U.S. indices, the S&P 500 in the upper left, the NASDAQ in the upper right, the Dow lower left, and the Russell 2000 in the lower right. We can see on three of the four, we can see consolidation patterns that I've drawn in, all that started back in the July-August timeframe. So let's focus here right now just on the S&P 500, the one on the left. And folks, when you can identify a consolidation, great patterns out there, you don't really have to be much of a technologist, so to speak, to identify these patterns. You're looking for where you have two common lows, two common highs, maybe you have more than two out there, but just a very clear consolidation. When I take a look at the S&P 500, that's what I've drawn in here. And the cool thing about a consolidation pattern is that when it's broken, it gives us a price projection, which you and I refer to as a measured move. And the measured move means it's really just taking the consolidation pattern that price was in, whichever side gets broken, the measured move is equal to or greater than the consolidation. So in this case here, the S&P 500 has a projection in a 3978 area. We're not going to use this right to the tick or anything along those lines. And so the S&P 500 is giving us a consolidation breakout method. Now, the NDX 100 is the same thing. And the NDX 100, 13,719, is its price target for its consolidation break. And inside the Dow, the price level gets us up to 32,190. In the case of the Dow, and really the S&P, I've drawn in a couple of resistance trend lines. I did the same thing for the NASDAQ, but it was more of a parallel line. And we can see that the Dow in the lower left-hand panel has run right into that trend line, hasn't been able to break through that level. Now, this is not to say that there can't be some detours along the way. And it's one of the reasons that I wanted to be with you for a few minutes today. If we take a look at, so one of the things that I do for newsletter subscribers is I provide them with, so they understand the patterns that we take a look at. When markets form tops and bottoms, three of the patterns I've automated, those patterns being what I refer to as the Rhodes Momentum Indicator signal. That's when price is either moving higher or lower, less relative energy or weakness. And so there's a whole series of five steps that I walk subscribers through. There's an archive workshop that folks can see. But here is a market analyzer, Tom, that scans whatever instruments I want. In this case here, we're taking a look at the cash indices, the index ETFs like the diamonds, the IWM, the Qs, the SPYs, the sectors with inside the S&P 500, the four U.S. equity future contract, metals, oil and gas. So it's got the majority of what it is that we here at TFNN and listeners take a look at. What this does is this provides the signal. So in one glance, I can take a look at the overall market or whatever I put into this to see if we've got any kind of top or bottom signal. So one of the other patterns that we take a look at is the TD9 count. And a valid pattern will show up on my screen as bars 8, 9, or it could be the bar after 9. So it will show up as a 1, and it will have a star next to it. If it's got a star next to it, it tells us that we have a confirmed TD9 count pattern. Now, not every TD9 count pattern identifies a top or a bottom, but in this case here, we have a plethora of topping signals, either Rhodes Momentum Indicator signals, TD9 counts, and I'm really right now just focused on the daily timeframes, although this tool here, this market analyzer, shows you what's going on in the weekly and on a monthly timeframe. And I've got several of the Chapman Wave, 7-Wave moves out there. So the cool thing about the consolidation pattern, the question is, which of these two are correct? Is it the consolidation or is it the TD9 count pattern? So for example, let me pull over the S&P 500. We'll just focus on that for a few moments. And on the S&P 500, here's the chart that basically all of this data was summarized on that market analyzer. Now, we're all visual, so many times it's easier to take a look at this chart to understand what's going on. But it's nice to be able to have an analyzer tool that gives you an overall view, kind of like a dashboard, of what's going on inside the market. If just one instrument is topping, okay, no big deal out here. But we had multiple instruments that are identifying those tops. Now, here's the S&P 500. The high of the S&P 500 came on Friday. That was bar number 8 of this TD9 count. Today is going to be bar number 9. So we've got a valid TD9 count. I'd mentioned when we were looking at that market analyzer that the star would be printed next to either bars 8, 9 or the bar following 9. So we really need to give it room tomorrow, because a higher high tomorrow doesn't negate the pattern. That just creates the overall wall of resistance. Right now it happens to be yesterday's high. Now, if this is going to be a topping pattern, Tom, we will see price close below what I like to refer to as Stevie's green line, green or red. It's actually the oscillator unchanged line. That for the S&P 500 right now is priced at 36.75. If we were to see it close below 36.75, that gives us a price projection target to the downside right now of 35.94. So in the S&P 500, we've got a topping pattern. I'd mentioned the NDX, which didn't have a confirmed TD9 count top as of Friday because bar number 8 was not the high. Well, today has taken care of that. So today is bar number 9 of a TD9 count. Again, tomorrow could be the higher high. That would be the end of the pattern. Now, the cool thing about these patterns is if they fail, if price closes over the high of the pattern, well, then that's the communication message to us that the consolidation patterns are going to go ahead and fulfill themselves or should fulfill themselves, unless there's some other topping signal that takes place in between now and then. But at this stage here, the cool thing about this pattern, it helps us to identify tops and bottoms, but it can also identify a strong momentum move to either the upside or the downside. In this case here, it would be an upside move if price is able to take out those patterns. So we should have a really good feel, folks, by Wednesday. I say tomorrow, Wednesday for sure, as to whether or not these signals are going to identify at least a short-term or intermediate-term market top out there. So that's what I've got.
Pretty cool, man. And you know what you have out here, folks, okay, which is intriguing inside the NDX. This is the ninth day, and the NDX has never moved 9 days up for the past year. So I know that's not a big number, but it actually is. So this is going to get – there's bulls and bears are fighting like crazy over these numbers, Steve.
They are. So, you know, one of the things I can do here, just while we have just a few seconds, is we've looked at the cash indices. Let me just put up the ES Mini. So I'm just going to move to the equity future contract here. And what I want folks to understand is it, too, has that topping signal. Now, the cool thing about the TD9 count pattern is it provides us with a clear breakout level and breakdown area. And the breakout level is 3682.50. And we can see on a short-term basis, this formed a TD9 count top, which took price right back to support that held at 3682.50. Yeah. So what I want folks to watch overnight, 3682.50 to the downside and 3700 to the upside. If either side of those get broken, that's going to tell you about where price is headed, or at least the direction as to where price is headed.
You got to love it. Folks, come over to our website at TFNN. You hit newsletters, you see Master and Probability right there. You can subscribe. And you are off to the races. Steve, have a great one, safe one, and we look forward to the show tomorrow.
Thanks, Tom.
Thank you. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
If you're not currently using the TAS Profile Scanner when looking at setting up your trading opportunities, then your arsenal is short a mighty weapon. The TAS Profile Scanner is a standalone piece of software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, TAS understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. You also gain access to the webinar that Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien just hosted, The Best Way to Use the TAS Profile Scanner to Profit. This webinar archive is available for all subscribers immediately upon signing up. All new subscriptions also come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Start your subscription by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services tab. Sign up today. Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today. TFNN has developed a daily programming lineup for traders by traders. We start every trading day live at 8:30 a.m. with Tommy O'Brien hosting the morning market kickoff as he starts the day off by breaking down everything you need to know about what's going on for the trading day ahead. At 9 a.m., Larry Pesavento takes your calls and questions live on the air for the opening bell as he hosts Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the Bull Bear Trading Hour. At 11 a.m., it's Kevin Hanks and Alex Coffey from TD Ameritrade Network with Fast Market. Basil Chapman at noon with the Tiger Technicians Hour. Steve Rhodes hosts the Trader's Edge at 1 p.m. Dave White with the Power Trading Hour at 2 p.m. And Tom O'Brien closes out the day for the final hour of trading live from 3 till 4. Don't miss a second of our daily programming lineup. Tune in to Tiger TV every trading day live at TFNN.com. Educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Back, folks. Dow Industrials right now down 180, 170. Nasdaq's up 49. S&P's are off 10. SPCE, where do you see this, folks? There's some stocks that are picking up some strength here, and it's pretty wild because, you know, my take is that we're at highs, but that being said, that doesn't mean a thing when you look at some of these equities. So Virgin Galactic, right? You had a high volume high first off at $27.85. That blew that away a couple weeks ago. Had volume behind the move. Well, this is a monster ABC structure up now, folks. Your B point out here is the 29.59. Your A point is 17.02. So you get approximately, what's that, 17.27, 12 points. Your C point is 26. So you're talking about 38 on the ABC structure. And, you know, bottom line, people are getting into new equities. I mean, I don't believe this has any revenue. Well, yeah, it's going to have all of $940,000 worth of revenue maybe this year. But bottom line, it's an ABC structure on the way up. That's how this baby is shaking out. So we don't necessarily have a full ABC structure market on the way up. In gold and silver, we absolutely do, okay? What will happen tonight, now this is going to get interesting. So the volumes come in at about 8 o'clock at night on the XAU and the HUI. Well, they're both blown away the B point, that's for sure. And I believe you're not going to need a lot of volume. All these other ones have already blown away. So we're going to need volume of more than 29 million. And the XAU, and this is going to put the XAU, let's just see here. So you get B is 143, 130. You get 14 bucks is going to get you into 38, 48, 152. That's 152. You're at 143 on the XAU. We go over and we take a look at the Gold Bugs Index. This is also a large move out here today. You're up $10.50. And this ABC structure, you only need 18 million. And that's 299. It's 25 bucks, $24. That's going to get you to 90. So 314. And you're at 302. So we're talking about some monster numbers out here, folks. No doubt about it. Let's go to Marty in Maryland. Hey, Marty, what's going on?
Hey, Tom. Good hearing from you again.
I know. I haven't heard from you for a while. How you been, man?
Yeah. Doing good.
Good.
The gold market's been treating me, got two or three doubles and a couple triples, so it's like
good.
Can't beat that on the small caps.
No, totally, man.
Yeah.
So.
Let's look at UNG, the natural gas.
Yeah.
I stuck my toe in the water this morning, but I'd like to go a lot more. I just put like 30% of what I wanted to put into it, but I dipped in at like 866, and I think we're going to probably go down below the 862 low already from today.
Okay, so let's take a look at it. I'm going to bring up the active contract first, and okay. We take a look at this contract. This contract's in tough space. Let me see this. I remember doing this. I think this is a... Okay, so it's an ABC down. The real question is, how big is it? If I do it this way, it's 320 to 260. So that's 60 cents. That gets you to 240 where we're at. Let me put this on NG1. I'll put on a generic one. So what we're doing, folks, is that we have an ABC down, a confirmed ABC down on the daily. Yeah, man, this is dangerous. So, you know, you go back and we came off 142 in June. You get all the way up to 339. You know, this thing can get down to 260. No, 202. And you're at 240. Okay, so now let's go back to the UNG. Okay, so I see what you're doing. What he's doing, folks, is that it took out a swing low, but 25 million, 18 million, No, 15 million versus 18 million. So it came into that swing low with monster volume. Yeah, I'd be real careful, man. I see what you're looking at, man, but I'm glad you only have 30% and you get your toe in instead of your foot.
I'm looking, you know, I'm looking maybe down into the high Q40s, maybe, or low 50s for the UNG. Excuse me, for the, no, that's a different price.
Well, just don't buy any more right now, man. You know, this is what you also have. So picture this. It's December 7th right now, right?
Right.
It's very unusual that natural gas would be going down in December. That natural gas only has like 80 days here to do anything.
Sure.
You know,
sure.
So evidently there's a lot of natural gas.
I'm just looking at, you know, it's making substantial lows, and, you know, I mean, we're going to get some cold weather. It's just, you know, when. But I understand, which usually you get around that third to fourth week of February, and, you know, they start changing things over, and that's, you know.
That's right, and that's when it's the coldest, too. I get that. I just think there's a lot easier trades out there for you, Marty. You know,
I understand.
I know people are going after it, man, but that's why they call it the Widowmaker, man. Have a great one, man.
God bless, sir.
Thank you.
Take care.
Totally, man. Thank you. Folks, as you come over to our website at TFNN, you know, we do these a couple times a year. And what I'm talking about is the Tiger Dollar Sale. So the way the Tiger Dollar Sale works, if you go to the TFNN, you're going to see it right on the featured content. The way the Tiger Dollar Sale works is that it ends, we just started it this morning, it ends on December 20th. You can make up to 40% on your money. The way this works is that Tiger Dollars are good for all product at TFNN, have no expiration date, and are totally transferable. If you buy $500 worth of Tiger Dollars, you get $600, $100 bonus. If you buy $1,000, you get $1,300, $300 extra. If you buy $1,500, you get $2,100 or $40, or $600 extra or 40%. If you get any subscriptions to TFNN right now, it's a great way to save money. If you're looking for anything in the future, also a great way to save money. And in that same context, our man, Mr. Larry Pesavento, you're going to see him right under featured content also. He's going to be doing a live trading webinar this Wednesday, 9 o'clock to 2 in the afternoon. It's live. It's only $295. You want to save some money, you get Tiger Dollars, you can sign up for it. And they're totally automated, folks. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors. If you're a trader in the market looking to find the path that leads to maximizing profits while decreasing risk, then now is a great time to try out Dave White's daily trading service, The Path of Least Resistance. Through the use of options and equity trades, Dave advises his subscribers on a daily basis of the current market conditions and what possible trade setups are on the horizon. The Path of Least Resistance is published every trading morning, often with updates intraday when initiating trades or closing out positions. Dave White has advised his clients of some outstanding winning options and equity trades in recent months, and now is a great time to try it out for yourself. New subscribers to the Path of Least Resistance receive a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the types of options and equity trades that are available by signing up for the Path of Least Resistance today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com and selecting the newsletter tab. Sign up today. Biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Direction's daily S&P Biotech 3x bull and bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrials right now are 204. Down 204. NASDAQ is up 36. S&Ps are up 15. And, you know, if we go take a look at Goldman Sachs out here, let's just pull up Goldman Sachs for a second. So Goldman Sachs trading at 238. The low for the year in Goldman is 130. The high is 250. And the reason I'm bringing up Goldman Sachs right now is not as to, well, actually, well, let me just pull this back. I want to see where this is at anyway. Okay, so you're back to right about where we went south. You know, that being said, what you're going to see out here, and this is going to be pretty wild, folks, watching this whole thing shake out. And what it is that Goldman has been doing a study about moving a very large part of its business, okay, to Palm Beach County. And I suspect that this is going to actually fly this time. You know, you get Goldman Sachs and Elliott Management are breathing new life into the decade-old idea of converting the Miami to West Palm Beach corridor into the southern hub for finance and investing. You know, what you have, you know, when you're talking about the finance market and trading in general, folks, it's where's the money? Well, guess what? The money has been in, you know, Palm Beach County for a huge amount of time. It's accelerated dramatically because of the tax implications, meaning that, you know, bottom line, state tax we don't have in Florida. You see a lot of these big dudes getting out of not just New York, higher tax structures. Because guess what? They can move wherever they want to move. Now, what does happen, you know, in Miami, I mean, Miami's a beautiful place, man. You know, the bottom line is that they have beautiful buildings. This is going to have heavy implications in New York, because once that you have a large broker-dealer, and the portion that they're thinking of moving is their asset management arm. And the asset management arm, folks, is a monster. That's where broker-dealers want to accumulate as many assets as they can because they make a certain amount of percentage on it. It's something you want to keep your eye on, man. You know, New York's getting hit kind of all over the place. And yes, there is only one New York. There's only one London. There's only one Singapore. You know, it's not going to be the end of the world for them. But I'll tell you something. If you have a few more large broker-dealers like that move down there, the real estate down there always has been very volatile, because what you have in Miami, and you've had forever, is you've had all the South American money that, you know, whether these countries are going downtown, the dirty money, you got everything in the world down in South America coming right into Miami. And that's not, in our lifetime, I haven't seen that even get close to stopping. You know, they calm it down for 4 or 5 years, then all of a sudden another country's going south. As that country goes south, all the money comes into Miami, they wash it, they clean it, they throw it back in the washing machine, and guess what? What ends up happening? All those buildings you see there, that's that money being put to work in the United States. And I expect that we're going to see some real movement of these financial companies down into those levels. And beside that, they'll save money. What if you're thinking of moving to Florida, right? This is something that you want to understand, though. It's really intriguing because all you keep hearing on a continual basis is that we don't have any state tax, and we don't. Our property taxes, folks, are huge. Because we don't have any state taxes, our property taxes are huge, okay? I'm just bringing that in the aspect that if you think you're going to move here and you're going to buy a house and all of a sudden at the end of the year you say, oh, I just saved $15,000 on my taxes. You might have saved $15,000 on your taxes, but you probably paid another $5,000 on top of where you just sold from. Because I do the numbers from here to Boston. And what ends up happening is that, let's say a house that is valued at $500 here and $1 million in Boston, they're going to be the same tax, you know, so that's a word to the wise. That's what it comes down to. 877-927-6648. The commodities. So check this out. This is, well, actually, someone just brought this up in the den. This kills me that I didn't get this equity either. Cameco, folks, okay, you talk about, now this is a, basically a distributor of uranium. It's one of the cigar mine is one of the largest in the world from uranium. This thing was a classic. It basically came down to strength, tremendously lighter volume, takes off topside. On the last 2 days, we just went, so check this out. This is pretty wild, man. On Friday, you went from a price point of 1030 to 1108. We gapped higher again this morning, went to 1265. Now, the reason I'm bringing this up has to do with the aspect that the bottom line is that this stock wants a lot higher price. That being said, my take is that we're at the beginning of a commodity bull market. I bring up iron ore. Watch this. You bring up iron ore. Iron ore right now, this baby in 6 months has gone from 650 a pound, a ton rather, 650 a ton, to 963. You bring up copper, okay? Copper, you know, copper's the one that started. Copper's been on a tear. I mean a monster tear. You bring up copper, in 6 months, copper's gone from 255 a pound to 350. My take is copper's going after its all-time high, folks. I'll put this up right now. I think it's 454. And I don't think anything's going to stop it. Let's see. 464. You know, you broke out of a consolidation that goes all the way back to 2013. You know, you broke out of it, and you broke out of it with conviction. Then let's go over to lumber. What you're going to see with lumber. Lumber already went to all-time highs, then gave it up, and then just came right back, roaring back, okay? So picture, in, what's that? In September, we had all-time high. It hit $1,000 for 100,000 board feet. You get down to to 490. Right now, you're already in the gap. You're at 697. Bottom line, it's going. And you can go through gold. You can go through silver. What's going to be intriguing is this, is that when I'm looking at this, the oil's absolutely moved. It's like, okay, is oil going to go exponential also? Because this is going to have to do with the good old U.S. dollar. The bottom line, as dollar gets lower, you know, the commodities themselves already start taking off. You know, the bottom line is that, yeah, you get 88 is the next take on the dollar. You know, the bottom line, you break 88, you're going to be down to 78 in a heartbeat, and the all-time lows right now, a 70 that were generated in 2008. So that's the way these commodities seem to be setting up. And, you know, as of today, you can see when these commodity stocks are taking off, they're breaking B points with volume. You break B points with volume, you get an ABC up market. Dow Industrial's down 214, NASDAQ up 26, S&P's down 15.5. We'll come right back.
In the day, I joined Hotel California in 2006, and like many of you, was drawn in by
bam!
As well as
whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows.
You see, I believe that everything in life happens for us, not to us, and Tom ignited the fire within me to want to learn how to master the markets. So how did I go from knowing nothing about technical analysis to becoming the number one market timer for the S&P 500 in 2018 and the number two market timer in 2019? Simply put, I hired coaches with a proven track record, which led me to a whole new set of tools that I created to interpret the message of buyers and sellers. I would love the opportunity to teach you this award-winning set of tools and help you improve your market timing. You can test drive my newsletter service, Mastering Probabilities, for the next 30 days with no risk to you. Plus, you'll gain access to archive workshops that'll take you step-by-step through my system. Sign up today by going to the homepage of TFNN.com and selecting Mastering Probability in the newsletter tab.
Bam!
With markets trading with extreme volatility and peaks and troughs everywhere, regardless of what you're looking at in the markets, this is a great time to see the type of analysis Basil Chapman delivers for his subscribers every market day with the Opening Call newsletter. Basil has been analyzing markets, providing his take for subscribers to his trading services since 1984. Every morning, Basil publishes an update for his subscribers, along with weekend and evening updates when warranted. The Opening Call provides traders a daily market overview with regard to the direction of the key indices, selective stocks and commodities, along with specific recommendations, including stops and targets. You also gain instant access to Basil's subscriber webinar archive from earlier this year, a dark cloud cover, an essential market analysis. Ride the Chapman wave today by signing up for the Opening Call newsletter on the front page of TFNN.com under the newsletter tab. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Sign up today.
Introducing Primal Edge.
Today, it's even more important to take a supplement that complements your health. Primal Edge is specifically formulated to boost your immune system and help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Our early ancestors found all their nutritional requirements in the wild environment. But today our food sources don't contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients that we need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated humic and fulvic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They've been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, without them, life cannot exist.
That's right, Ellen. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge. Just $89. Exclusively at TFNN.com.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Welcome back, folks. Dow's down 193. You get the NASDAQ up 34. S&P's are down 13.5. And if we go over to the volumes, folks, you're going to have a short volume. I'm going to do the NASDAQ composite first because as you're breaking highs, of course, the volume should expand. Bottom line is you're going to have a contraction of volume when, in fact, we had a contraction the last couple of days. We're at 4.2 billion. That'll do about 4.7. If we look at the Qs, you're going to see it inside the Qs. Qs traded to an all-time high today. Look like they're going to close at an all-time high. You're up $1.20. You've only done 14 million shares. 14 million. And you took out a swing high that had 50 million. That's pretty amazing. We go to the SPY. We take a look at the SPY. SPY's laying at highs. Didn't take out Friday's, but bottom line, another contraction. 37 million versus Friday out here at 50 million. And, of course, your November 9th area had 172 million. So the bottom line is that You have higher price. You don't have buyers up at these levels. Hanging at these levels, though, that's the bottom line. There's no doubt about it. It's hanging at these levels. We'll see where this whole baby does shake out. We go take a look at the NYSE, Dow Industrials. Same thing. It's going to be a contraction of volume out here today inside the Dow. We've done $624 million thus far. We did that'll put it out about 800, maybe 850, and you're going into a billion. The GDX, you can expect on the GDX, it's an ABC structure on the way up. We already get 19.9 million. You need 21, I believe. We need 21. You'll get that coming into the close, I suspect, because we're almost at 20 inside the GDX, as they do with the IWM. Bottom line is that that gets a huge amount of volume coming into the close. Tomorrow morning, folks, our man, Mr. Basil Chapman, he is going to have a nice little special for you. He's going to be kicking us off at TFNN at 8 o'clock in the morning. So normally we kick off at 8:30 in the morning. Tommy kicks us off. Great show. Basil's going to kick us off tomorrow. So come join us tomorrow, 8 o'clock. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. And whatever you want in life, folks, visualize it like a nice big motion picture. Step into it, take ownership of it, and fly with it. Thanks for being here, folks. Have a great night. Have a safe night. Come back and visit us tomorrow. Basil's going to kick us off 8 o'clock. Tommy's right after him. Larry, whole crew. Have a great one, folks. Have a safe one. Yeah, look at him, folks.